Hello everyone. Today we will be showcasing our dashboard Socio Discovery, which is a quest to match up government open data for insights. We have built this dashboard for the challenge post summer jam open data mashup. Okay, so we all hear about how literacy, population, health, growth are interrelated. But are they? Let us try to find out. So what we have here are some dashboards which we have built using government and World Bank data of the 35 different states of India, and we see how these states are performing against each other and how various KPIs are correlated. So we move on. We have a total of around 5 different dashboards that we have. We look at the government data of the state based on the sex ratio, child mortality, literacy, birth control, and finally the financial analytics. So first, sex ratio analytics. Okay, so what we have here is the total sex ratio of India. Sex ratio and the literacy ratio is defined as the number of females per 1,000 males. As you can see, India as a country has a sex ratio of around 942 in 2011. Let us try to compare this against the literacy of India. If we see this chart, we see a direct correlation between the sex ratio and the literacy rate. As the literacy rate increases, the sex ratio is also higher. Let us do some playing around with the data. I'll say select the top two bands of the literacy, and I can see a direct jump on the sex ratio. If I select one, it's more than 1,000. So we can see that literacy is very, very important in terms of the society, and high literacy rate leads to better sex ratio, which is beneficial to the society. As you can see around here, you can also play around with the data over here and move on. Moving on, I'll clear out the filters. Moving on, I'll move on to the next sheet, which analyzes the child mortality. As you can see over here, this information gives the various states and the record of child deaths in the age group of 0 to 5 years. As number one, we are looking at the health of mothers at the time of childbirth, then sanitation facility, as well as the government hospitals. As you can see, again, there is almost a direct correlation. And here is number one, if in case of better health of mother at the time of pregnancy or with better healthcare and with better sanitation facilities, the child deaths would reduce. Moving on, next is a dashboard on the literacy. The entire literacy information is being plotted on the map. As you can see that higher poverty means lower literacy rate, whereas lower poverty means high literacy rate. Moving on, next dashboard looks into the various birth control methods that we have gathered from the information from the Health Management Information System of India. You can obviously go in and filter out and see how they stack up. Moving on, the last one over here, the financial analytics. What we try to analyze over here is the net domestic product ratio, which is the net domestic product of the state in 1,000 rupees, Indian rupees, per total population of the state. The information that we get is that, yes, higher literacy rate means higher net domestic product. So that's all, and finally we conclude this demonstration with a bit of insights that we have gathered. Number one, high literacy means we have better sex ratio, which is beneficial to the society. High literacy rate in females leads to better sex ratio. Higher net domestic product, irrespective of the population density, is achieved because of high literacy. Next, we understand that better health of mother at time of pregnancy, better healthcare and sanitation facilities can lead to decrease in care standards. And lastly, obviously, which everyone knows, that female literacy is very important for the growth of the nation. Thank you.